One second, ma'am. We request all other participants.
Today is a Guru Purnima and I am inviting PMA introduce subcommittees and we are part of.
Last time we had him work through understanding user experience. Today he will work us through a new thing, which is about crafting your customer's journey in the digital age. So this will actually help you to achieve your business goals. Brief about Mr. Gopinathan. He brings more than 2 decades plus of work ex in GCC, Africa, APAC and India, and had exposure in the full spectrum of sales, business development, strategic planning, operations functions while working with organizations like Desert Line Projects, Dalsco, Tata Capital, Reliance Communications and many more. He has, Mr. Rakesh is a commerce graduate with MBA in marketing. He specializes in sales and has completed his honors diploma in sales and marketing from NIS Sparta. In the initial years of his and business development career, he had greater insights into channel management, business unit operations, revenue generation and many more. Later on, he worked with some Fortune top 500 companies, including DHL, Tata and Reliance. He has, with this, I would like to hand it over to ma'am, Anita ma'am.
Rakesh Gopinathan, we will start with the presentation and your webinar.
Done. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Namrata. I see the happiness on your t-shirt. So happiness is that we plan to create also in this session. So great going. Thank you so much, Namrata, for that wonderful introduction with regards to, you know, my profile. Thank you so much. First of all, let me wish you all a happy Guru Purnima and then start with, because without humble salutations to the lotus feet of our gurus, we are nothing. I've learned several things in the past from a lot of other people. You learn a lot from people who are your gurus and otherwise also. So don't worry about it. We are going to learn nothing that is, you know, completely new, but we are going to understand how the entire journey of, you know, giving that excellent experience to your customer has evolved with the intervention of technology. So what you see here on the screen is basically a customer experience, which is denoted by CX, and JM basically looks for journey mapping. So ये जैसा कि अगर आप अहमदनगर से जो है पुणे तक आना चाहते हैं तो कौन से रास्ता आना पसंद करेंगे, and उस रास्ते में आपको कहाँ कहाँ रुक के क्या क्या खाना है, कितने बार ब्रेक लेना है, क्या रफ्तार में आपको गाड़ी चलानी है, आपका उस ट्रैवल का उद्देश्य क्या है, उस हिसाब से जो है यू विल बी बेसिकली डूइंग योर एंटायर experience of, you know, getting into that journey. Similarly, customer experience also works in this manner. Now, I've so far done about close to 1,300 sessions. This is my 1,310th session. Before we get into a customer journey map, I have a few set of questions that I will ask you, because I'm used to having this, you know, discussion with each one of you to understand your understanding with regards to your customer journey. We will summarize the varied touch points which we are going to get into, list out the steps that would be ideally there for a customer journey map, both in a digital space, which is e-commerce, B2C, B2B, B2I, and B2 enterprise mode, and recognize the moments of truth that is very critical for us to evaluate. So if I proceed further, now, what do you think makes a customer loyal? What do you think makes a customer stick with you? What do you think makes the customer's pulse and heartbeat go with you? Anybody can answer this question, because this is the fundamental of setting an experience and a journey map. So what do you think, if one of you can...
Sir, may I try?
Yeah, please go ahead, please.
Repeat customer.
Repeat customer, okay. Kya cheez jo hai, customer ko aapke taraf loyal banati hai?
Sir, I think customer, after taking reviews of customer, if we change the product continuously, right, and also the after sales service. So these are the two things which I feel are the key to making anyone loyal.
Okay, wonderful. Anybody else?
Quality and service.
Quality and service. Okay.
If you do best quality and service, customer will be always be with you. Will be always loyal to you.
Amazing. Excellent. Anybody else?
Sir, when Agav says that rapport and service along with quality, good quality.
Good quality.
Communication with customer.
Wonderful. Tell me something, if you're hungry today, you're hungry at this moment in time, you want to have a cup of tea, a masala tea, and you want to have bakarwadi. Let's say, for instance, if you get it right now, what is your experience?
I'm totally satisfied.
You're delighted? And if it is wonderful tea and agar aapko bhook bhi lage, toh experience kaisa rahega?
It's a wow experience.
So please understand, there are a couple of things that is aligned to create a customer experience which is there and to create a customer loyalty. Agar aap ek situation ko dekhte hain, jahan pe aapko jo hai, you want somebody to change your tire while you're on the highway and aapko koi mil nahi raha hai, and all of a sudden somebody comes and helps you out, you feel elevated. That experience comes at that moment, that situation, and most importantly, how does a person, he or she, behave to the customer at that moment in time? So the first thing that you need to keep in mind is every step of the customer journey you have to measure, because customer's requirement keeps changing. Customer's need keeps changing. Hence, one product will not be a fit-all basis for everything. Every product is looked at in the perspective of, or the service is looked at in the perspective of, what is my need out of that particular product. Now, the second thing that we all need to pay attention to is every customer specifically is driven by different needs. So, hum sir ke saath baat kar rahe the, to wahan pe ek discussion hai, main Eureka Forbes mein tha. Every product is uniquely, distinctly of different use and application to the customer. For example, agar main aapke yahan se jo hai ek Hyundai Ion aapke showroom se leta hu, wahan pe agar main apne bachchon ke liye purchase karta hu, to uski requirement kuch aur hai, taki मैं अपने बच्चों को जो है स्कूल और अपने घर के बीच में कम्यूट कर पाऊं, और वो छोटी गाड़ी जहां पे स्कूल में इतने सारे लोग जब पिकअप के लिए आते हैं, तो ये गाड़ी जाके उनको साधारण तरीके से पिकअप कर सकती है, मेरा कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव हो सकता है, एंड बच्चों के लिए लेके आने के लिए, इवन इफ माय वाइफ वांट्स टू ड्राइव और इफ आई पुट अ ड्राइवर आल्सो, इट इज इजी. द सेम कार फॉर अ फैमिली ऑफ फोर पीपल हु आर फ्रॉम अ सब लो मीडियम इनकम क्लास फैमिली इज ऑफ अ डिफरेंट रिक्वायरमेंट. They want to drive between, let's say, Pune, Ahmednagar or Nasik frequently because they go during the weekend to their parents. And they want an economical car in which they get 21 kilometers per liter. Four people can travel. And if four people travel, they're able to stop at their own this thing because they have some medical condition. So, we need different time. So, her product, her customer ke liye alag tarike se dekha jata hai, and hence, the loyalty factor also changes. Now, this calls in for something which is called a customer persona. Do you understand what a customer persona is? What do you mean by a customer persona? My screen is currently on, so I believe I'm hearing your voice. Am I right?
Yes, sir. Listen, Namrata.
Now, yeah. There are segment of people, Namrata ji, thank you so much for answering these queries. Now, there are segment of people who dress for occasions, dress based on, you know, what dress that they have. They get in matching colors and shades. They also basically get the color palettes based upon the environment that they walk into, which means the business environment or a casual environment or a sub-casual environment. Now, when you build a customer persona for Nykaa, Nykaa is looking at people from varied age segments. It is also looking at specifically gender-oriented requirements of cosmopolitan cities, metropolitan cities, urban, rural and semi-rural segment, which is there. तो ये सारी चीजों को मद्देनजर रखते हुए आपको एक बायर पर्सोना क्रिएट करना है या कस्टमर पर्सोना क्रिएट करना है. एंड दिस पर्टिकुलर पर्सोना, लाइक नम्रता मेंशन, नॉट ओनली हैज कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, इट हैज गॉट समथिंग व्हिच इज कॉल्ड एज अ फंडामेंटल नीड एट दैट पॉइंट इन टाइम. सो इट इज अ टाइमलाइन ड्रिवन रिक्वायरमेंट, वेरन इफ नम्रता इज टुडे अ टीनेजर एंड इज मूविंग इनटू लेट्स से हर 20s एंड लेट 20s वेयर शी इज गोइंग टू बेसिकली मूव इनटू वर्क, हर प्रेफरेंसेस वुड वाइडली चेंज. वुड यू एग्री टू दैट, नम्रता?
Yes, sir. Definitely.
Hence, in that case, the customer journey basically takes care of three things. One, a pre-sale, a sale, and being a customer. So, in the pre-sale, we do basically which is called as market research. But when it comes to business to enterprise, business to business, pre-sale is basically crafting a solution around what is the requirement of the client. But pre-sale essentially in an e-commerce and other industry is to do a pilot to understand which particular product or which particular service suits a certain segment of category of people with certain characteristics, needs, requirements, and wants, which means desire to move forward. When the sale happens, which is when the customer buys your product, the customer has an expectation and the sale meets that expectation. But being a customer is totally a different thing. So once again, if I come back to Namrata, who has in future. So which means you had been a customer, you tested their products, you tested for how long, Namrata, before you made the next purchase?
So maybe I personally did it once, because after that I have got friends in my circle who have also purchased, you know, many other things. So getting the feedback, it was a good experience for most of us.
Wonderful.
So that is why I relied on the products and I relied on the brand. And next time I got more.
Excellent. So when being a customer, you are also trying to validate the purchase that you made. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Similarly is the case not only with Namrata. Even if you buy an automobile, you buy a mixie, you buy a TV or anything for that matter of fact, and you want to further upgrade anything or continuously purchase from the same brand. After being a customer, the customers in today's digital world get to each other very soon. They discuss problems, they discuss solutions, they also discuss based upon the personas that they carry. For example, if Namrata is in a certain age bracket, she would have also peers in the same age bracket and discuss along with them, who could be even friends, who could be working colleagues or otherwise. Now, what is essential here is the term customer loyalty is still not in place. It is customers' recognition of the product, assessment of the brand, assessment most importantly of the usage of the brand and the application of the brand. And hence this customer journey is very important to be understood in a pre-sale stage, a sales stage, and being a customer stage. Because if you want your customer to remain with you, as we call this terminology called as customer lifetime value, which is the amount of money he or she will spend on your product based upon the requirements that they have over a period of time, including their longlihood of consumption, would determine how much of business they would do with you. Hence, you need to take care of this journey, and every product or service that you offer on your digital space, for example, be it on Amazon, Flipkart, or even on your own e-commerce portal, anything that you do has got a pre-sale, sales, and being a customer judgment. The third most important thing after this is consider the map to introduce your new products. Because once you have used this new product, so Nykaa's business model, why I'm discussing today, is because Nykaa tried and tested this business model for the youth segment and the sub-youth segment, which is basically even school-going children, to introduce new products to fit into their kitty of requirement. Kitty of requirement means aapke parents aapko itna paisa dete hain, usme se aap itna spend kar sakte hain, and utne spend ke liye aap kya kya unko de sakte hain, provision kar sakte hain. Plus, any child who goes in an Indian market, basically from the rural segment or the sub-rural segment or even the metropolitan segment or tier B, tier 3 cities, go along with their friends or parents to purchase the product. Now, Nykaa have given you a platform to purchase this product on a platform which is digitally available for you to make decisions, try it, test, and then use. So that's how the quantity size packaging also is made here with Nykaa. Now, journey mapping. Why bother about journey mapping? Now, with this understanding, I wanted to ask you all, जैसे कि आप consulting service में भी हो सकते हैं, आप trainer भी हो सकते हैं, आप जो है एक ISO process भी ला सकते हैं, आप किसी company के लिए काम भी कर सकते हैं, colleges के लिए भी काम कर सकते हैं. So I want all of you to sit down and pen down a few points to tell me why bother to create this journey map? Why is it important? Why is it important? And I will tell you this with a story, but before that, I want to hear from you. Why is this journey mapping so critical? Ye kyun itna critical hai? Pehle bhi critical tha, lekin aaj ke mahol mein bahut hi critical hai. And kyun critical? So I'm going to stop sharing the screen and I'm going to come back to the window, which is where all of you are there. If you can kindly...
Sir, I can...
Yeah, please go ahead.
So, sir, the customer journey is critical because, you know, what happens in your past. Okay, so if you don't collect those experiences and learn from them and, you know, strategize to work upon your where you've gone wrong in the past, so you cannot increase your driving skills or you cannot use it to your advantage. So, this is the things I can think of.
Excellent point. Anybody else?
Yeah, Rakesh, I want to say something.
बताइएगा.
इट नीड नॉट बी इन कॉस्मेटिक्स प्रोडक्ट्स, इट कुड बी इन टर्म्स ऑफ लेट्स से बाइंग अ वेकेशन पैकेज.
एक्सीलेंट.
सो द सप्लायर विद द कम्स टू नो द प्रोफाइल ऑफ द कस्टमर, हिज टेस्ट्स. And in future, if he wants to, if he maintains a journey, if he maintains a database of the taste of a particular customer, he can create a profile. And in future, he will be able to sell a new package altogether.
Package, wonderful. That's an excellent thought process. Excellent. That's Nikunji. You have come to the point almost. But I have a question once again to the audience. What is this?
Just Sanjay tells, he's written in the chat that to have sustained business growth.
Okay. And Rohit also says that to satisfy the problem of the customers in a better way. Wonderful. Achha, ek sab, aap sab se ek baat puchna chahta hun. We all have normal menu food at home. Am I right? Lekin aisa bhi to nahi hai ki hum log nayi cheeze jo hai, hum log bahar jaake try nahi karte. Aisa to nahi hai. Ye, agar main shuddha shakahari hun ya mamsahari hun. शाकाहारी हो तो शाकाहारी खाना ट्राई करता हूं, लेकिन अलग अलग ट्राई करता हूं. ट्राई करता हूं कि नहीं करता हूं. आपकी देयर इज समथिंग विच इज कॉल्ड एज अ सैटिस्फैक्शन एंड अ यूटिलिटी आउट ऑफ द फर्स्ट परचेज. देन यू हैव समथिंग विच इज कॉल्ड एज एनहांस एक्सपेक्टेशन टू ट्राई समथिंग न्यू. फॉर एग्जाम्पल नम्रता मेंशन द फैक्ट एंड यू नो अदर्स हैव ऑल्सो मेंशन दिस. आपकी एक्सपेक्टेशन एक और लेवल हाई हो जाती है कि ये प्रोडक्ट अच्छा है, अगला हम लोग ट्राई करके देखते हैं. अगला जिसमें जो है प्रोडक्ट ऑलरेडी इन एक्सिस्टेंस है, बट लेकिन कस्टमर के नीड और रिक्वायरमेंट प्लस वांट में शिफ्ट आ चुकी है. वेयर ही वॉज इज नाउ मूव टू अ नेक्स्ट लेवल. सो ही इज नॉट द बेसिक अलाइंड कस्टमर, ही इज एट अ लेवल अबव. इफ यू सी इन द ऑटोमोबाइल सेगमेंट, अर्लियर ऑल द कार्स दैट वर मेड वर बॉक्स कार्स, देन दे स्टार्टेड अलाइनिंग what is the feel and look that they want inside, plus essentially body color kis tarike ke hone chahiye, kya kya features gaadi ke andar honi chahiye. The requirement between a male dominated category to a female category had completely gone a paradigm shift. And aap jo hai iske liye jo bol nahi sakte ki Honda Civic jo hai ek gaadi jo hai main karunga ladies ke liye, dusri gaadi jo banaunga apne batch process gents ke liye, ye to ho nahi sakta hai, sambhav nahi hai. Hence a collaborative product for people to generate today, which is today brands like Nissan, Honda, Mercedes-Benz, all these people come together to create a wonderful customer experience by integrating these surveys together and to create something which is called an integrated services of solution to fit into a product. Yehi hum log abhi seekhne ki koshish karenge, jo aap sabko pehle malum hoga, lekin aajkal ke modern methodology mein ये डेटा पॉइंट्स जो आपके पास आते हैं बहुत जल्दी आते हैं, बिकॉज आपके पास बहुत ही कम वक्त होता है डिसीजन लेने का. एंड हेंस आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू पे अटेंशन टू द स्लाइड दैट आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर विद यू राइट नाउ, व्हिच इज कॉल्ड अ रिकर्सिव लूप ऑफ लर्निंग फ्रॉम राइट.
Yes.
With this said, he becomes an active evaluator. आप उसको including अगर गाड़ी का चेसी भी हो उसको आपको एक डंपर में बदलना है, किसी और चीज में भी बदलना है, तो वो भी आप कर सकते हैं. Then comes a moment of purchase. The moment of purchase is when the person gives you the money and sees the return on purchase. There is a terminology that is today in use which is called a return on purchase. It is different from a return on investment. Return on purchase means aapke end user jaisa ki agar aapne gaadi khareedi to aapka end user jo bhi hoga family mein ya aapka driver hoga ya aap hi honge, usme se jo hai the moment of purchase se hum log ye evaluate karne ki koshish karte hain is what is the cost of ownership and the ease of cost of ownership. This ease of use of cost of ownership is basically considered something as called the post purchase experience. How easy is it to procure? For example, agar aap ek printer khareedte hain aur uske sath cartridge aati hai, how easily are you able to procure the cartridge, service the printer in case the drum goes wrong, ya jahan pe aap ink fill karte hain to wo kaise kaam karta hai. This basically creates something which is called as a loyalty rule. So there is the first stage purchase, then there is a repurchase, and there is an experience to the repurchase, and that all becomes a moment of purchase. So the customer who sells or gets a car to his house has a moment of purchase every time he goes through the service as well. So that is one aspect that you have to understand when it comes to journey mapping with regards to either a B2C or a B2B, because B2B mein you'll be frequently aligned with the customer, and hence the post purchase experience, where the purchase moves from the purchase person or the person who's from finance to a person who's the periodic user, and the feedback from the periodic user leads to something which is called as a loyalty loop, wherein they become possible advocates of your product or service. The second thing that you need to understand is why we are talking about these maps. Understand the true journey of the customer. Every customer has got his or her own requirement. In terms of B2B, we call this, which is called as a KPI, a key performance indicator for a person who's in purchase, to prove a point to the business saying that, why did I procure this particular product and what difference will it make for my internal users? So we need to understand this journey. We need to understand in the B2C segment about this journey. The second most important part is you have to look from the perspective outside. Aajkal itne sare agencies user experience or customer journey map ko leke itna research kyun kar rahe hain? They are doing this because today's mindset of a product and the loyalty concept of the product is fast and dynamic. People are influenced by peer. People are influenced by others' reviews. People follow other people. People are influenced by other people. And also in the B2B environment, most businesses try to compete with competition and want an edge over and above what the current competition is having. And hence, you have to shift your perspective outside in and not inside out. That is where the entire process of re-engineering comes into place. Never in the history of automobiles, a car has been modified over a period of 5 years, at least 12 times. And this is not only true for just Indian cars, overseas cars as well. Earlier, a mobile or variant of a car used to be there in the market for at least 36 months. Today, a variant of the car is in the market for less than 15 months. That is the kind of periodic review that people are going with. Second thing that you need to do and understand is every customer's goal is changing. जैसे कि अभी आपको बताया गया कि गवर्नमेंट जो है टैक्स सब्सिडीज दे रही है ईवी व्हीकल पे. सो द एंटायर पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ द कस्टमर हैज चेंज्ड. दे वांट हाइब्रिड व्हीकल्स. पीपल हु आर ट्राइंग हाइब्रिड व्हीकल्स एंड द परसेंटेज ऑफ इंक्रीज इन टर्म्स ऑफ सेल्स हैज गॉन अप बाय अबाउट 58%. पीपल आर वेटिंग फॉर द राइट हाइब्रिड व्हीकल टू कम इनटू द मार्केट. दे आर विलिंग टू इन्वेस्ट बट दे आर नॉट विलिंग टू इन्वेस्ट इनटू द इंटरनल कंबस्टन इंजन व्हीकल्स व्हिच इज आइदर पेट्रोल और डीजल. For them to basically run it for the next 10 years because aapki lifetime value of the vehicle is only 10 years. So they're not wanting to purchase it and they're not very sure if you'll get an extension further. Now, as we go this, you can basically, as indicated by others also in this session, stress test new products. Stress test. What I mean by stress test is, today a product or a service before it is introduced into the market has got three test stages. Alpha, beta and gamma stage. The gamma stage is where the actual purchase happens or the moment of purchase happens. In the first two stages, the product is brought out to basically test. For example, about 6 years back, McDonald's brought in something which is called as tandoori products, including tandoori paneer, tandoori fries, which is there. And uske alawa jo hai, they brought in the non-veg segment of also products for the services of the customer. Unhone isko chote-chote points mein dikhaya. Kaise? आपसे ये लोग जो है आपका मोबाइल नंबर लेते हैं. उसके बाद इनके सिस्टम में एक ट्रिगर आता है जिससे आप पता चलता है कि हाउ पीरियोडिकली आर यू कमिंग टू मैकडॉनल्ड्स और लेट्स से केएफसी. एंड देन दे एक्चुअली गिव यू दिस प्लेटर फॉर यू टू टेस्ट. एंड वंस दे टेस्ट दिस, दे आर ट्राइंग टू प्ले अराउंड विद द प्रेफरेंसेस. दे गिव यू अ फीडबैक फॉर्म एंड दे गिव यू अ लॉयल्टी फॉर्म. एंड कभी कभी अगर आपके टेस्ट प्रेफरेंसेस बहुत ही अच्छे होते हैं तो आपको वो टेस्ट करने के लिए भी बुलाते हैं. जैसे कैडबरी जो है अपने प्रोडक्ट्स के लिए अपने ही कस्टमर्स को इनवाइट करती है न्यू प्रोडक्ट लॉन्च के पहले, विच इज बेसिकली डन थ्रू अ स्ट्रेस टेस्ट. अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज वंस यू हैव मैप्ड द चेंजेस विच इज द प्रेफरेंस ऑफ कस्टमर्स. मतलब कि कस्टमर यहां पे था और कस्टमर कल यहां पे जा रहा है. ये प्रेफरेंस जैसे शिफ्ट होता है आपका प्रोडक्ट अलाइनमेंट एंड फीचर प्लस वॉट एवर एडवांटेजेस दैट यू गिव टू द कस्टमर हैज आल्सो गॉट टू चेंज. बट मोर इंपॉर्टेंटली द कस्टमर एक्सपीरियंस अबाउट what they were expecting also should be in relationship. And you can plan for long-term improvements wherein you not only create the product, but also you create the customer experience, which means अगर आपका प्रोडक्ट जैसे कि एक ऑटोमोबाइल हो या कोई इंजीनियरिंग प्रोडक्ट हो, उस प्रोडक्ट की या उस सर्विस की एक लाइफ टाइम वैल्यू होती है जिसके लिए कस्टमर ने उसे प्रोक्योर किया. सो यू हैव अ रिटर्न ऑन परचेज फॉर द सर्विसेज दैट दे कंटिन्यूअसली डू. देन देयर इज रिटर्न ऑन एंगेजमेंट विद द सर्विसेज दैट यू डिलीवर. द थर्ड थिंग इज रिटर्न ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट फॉर व्हाटएवर प्रोडक्ट हैज रीच्ड देयर शॉप फ्लोर. एंड हेंस व्हाट बिकम्स इंपॉर्टेंट इज टू प्लान दीज चेंजेस इन कस्टमर एक्सपीरियंस right from the production stage or the R&D stage till the service level stage where it is a deliverable. When you do this, the current customer experience map can ideally put a graph across to say where your expectations are leading. So aajkal hum log kya karne ki koshish kar rahe hain, hum log apne customers ki requirement ko extrapolate karne ki koshish kar rahe hain. Kaise extrapolate karne ki koshish kar rahe hain? Udaharan ke liye, if I tell you with an example, I am using one product, somebody who's my friend who's based in US is using another product from the same company, but the experience is a total different experience. My expectation is risen higher. And hence, companies who basically produce different products in different geographies try to bring in an alignment of product also into our segment. Example, पहले जो है कार्स जब लॉन्च होती थी तो दुबई या यूएस या probably मलेशिया सिंगापुर में लॉन्च होती थी और यहाँ पे बाद में आती थी. आजकल देयर इज अ कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ अ यूनिवर्सल लॉन्च. द प्रोडक्ट इज फेल्ट अक्रॉस एवरीवेयर, बट जैसे आपकी लॉयल्टी सेगमेंट है, कस्टमर सेगमेंट है, उस हिसाब से आप प्रोडक्ट को उस जगह लॉन्च करते हैं. नाउ व्हाई दिस इज डन इज दिस इज टू स्टे अहेड ऑफ कॉम्पिटिशन, विच मीन्स वेन यू गिव द प्रोडक्ट फर्स्ट टू द कस्टमर. एग्जाम्पल एम जी हेक्टर जैसे मार्केट में आया, किया जैसे मार्केट में आया, पीपल वर वेटिंग टू ब्रिंग दिस. नाउ टूडे देर वुड बी मोर देन हाफ अ डजन मोर mid-size SUVs which will come into the market for the case of safety and others, where people are purchasing also that with an hybrid option. Hence, what you're trying to do is you're trying to bring in something into the market which is much more advanced. Now, why people are going to an MG Hector and not coming to a Kia, not coming to, let's say, an XUV 500 or even a moment of truth for other Mahindra vehicle, 80% information leke aata hai, to aapko kam se kam jo hai 120 ya 150% prepared hona padega. System would sometimes become a 2-year plus a 2-year experience on the field. Everything can happen, but what predominantly needs to understand that?
Yeah, Rakesh, I have a question.
Please, sir.
Most of these examples that you say, I come from background of engineering software applications.
Right.
So I wanted to correlate this, all these incidences or examples that you have cited to my industry. How am I to correlate?
What kind of banking software or solutions
do you offer? No, not banking, it's engineering.
Engineering. So what kind of engineering solutions do you offer, sir?
We offer automation solutions.
You automation services for plant?
In pharmaceutical industries, oil and gas industries, or chemical industries, petrochemical industries, we offer those engineering solutions.
Okay. Nukunji, for the solution that you offer, has a relevancy with regards to time and application. Am I right?
Sure. Yes.
Right? Now, the relevancy, which is with the application of time and whatever other enablers are there, are your actual customer journey map methodologies. So, for instance, if you're going into an organization which is very, very primitive with regards to getting a solution in, you would be at a wow stage in a customer experience. But for those who are already there in the market, you would be still at a category A or a category B or a category C. Now, what you essentially need to do is, first, understand where is your customer in the entire acceptance theory of your solutions or products. First thing that you have to understand is that. Second thing that you need to understand is what is the maturity level of the customer in terms of bringing in further future enhancement. Because zahir hai ki agar aap solutions dete hain, to solutions improve bhi ho sakti hain. Because you call management and industrial sales. I would tell you something which is called as, you have a sheet which is called as a key account map sheet. Do you have a key account map sheet for your customers, correct? In which you basically plot the current requirements, the intermediate requirements, and the future requirements. This is evaluated based upon the design. It is also evaluated based on user preferences. And what is the future user preferences depending upon the key account customers' requirement of competition. Please note this. Now, what I mean by this is, for example, I bring in something as an industrial product into my shop floor. Now, I need to enhance this based upon the changing requirement of the other applications also that I completely function with, because this is an integrated environment. When I talk about an integrated environment, you're not only just selling a product, you are basically marrying the product to the system. And when you're marrying the product to the system, it is just not important for you to evaluate only your product. You have to evaluate the complete periodic development of all the other aligned products and services in that integrated system. So this is where for industrial selling and for key account sales, it is very important to create something which is called as the ask, the must, and most importantly, what is the future defined need of the customer. So Nikunj ji, agar aap apne key account managers ko late hain, which is basically called strategic account management, where you are partnering with the organization to release a new version of a solution depending upon the future needs based upon certain critical assessments and analysis, which is technical assessments and analysis, which is done by both your pre-sales team once again with the same customer. Because please mind it, Nikunj ji, ki aapke product, your service mein enhancement aane wali hai. That's one. The second thing that is there is what is the bandwidth of this new product and solution that you introduce to this customer, which can be introduced also to other customers, because it has to be economically viable. Otherwise, your key account manager who's aligned with SKF should have so much of deal size that your entire R&D cost and the cost of complete development and bringing it onto the shop floor should suffice, which is usually not the case, which means you will have a larger period of return, and hence that larger period of return would not be viable for the project enhancement. Third most important thing which is there is, how often do you basically study the KPIs of the client before you study the KPI of your product and solution? Which means, what is the changing dynamics of the industry in that they operate? And this industry where they operate, basically, what are the current frequent changes and requirement that they need? When you do this close analysis, that's where key account management also brings in future predictions with regards to future enhancement of product and services that is required. Hence, it is important for all of you to join and draw a map across for you to basically create this complete specific product mapping. So Rahul ji ne ek important question pucha hai. Industrial products ke liye kaise customer journey map ki jati hai? Are you giving just a product for the specific customer as a product, let's say Grundfos pump X, this series goes for this, or it is further customized? For example, if we give the same Grundfos pumps, which is there in the oil and gas industry, it has to be further tweaked. So then again, entire process of understanding the design, understanding what is the requirement, and the entire process is done to the catering based upon the RFQ or the RFP that has been asked. But the question now to ask all of you is, every customer, every department, every function within the organization has a different need. And when you have a different need, and if it is a key account, which is going to give you, let's say, 500,000, 600,000, jo 6 lakh, 7 lakh rupay ka revenue every month periodically, then you need to find out a moment of truth to identify whether this customer is worth the investment to create a specific map. Because customer journey map create karna bahut aasan nahi hai. Please understand, it needs practice, it needs learning. Most importantly, your person should be a subject matter expert to understand.
Activity of the entire system, sales and marketing system, market research, etc., in my opinion, would be to create an emotionally bonded customer, someone who can be a net promoter and be a reference point for others in industry, and hence the concept of customer lifetime value is important. Because suppose he's valued, you value his entire business at 10 lakhs today. Actually, we are also to consider what is the additional revenue we will get by pulling in all the references that he will provide. So what appears 10 lakhs of business is actually perhaps a crore or more of business.
Absolutely right.
So the entire effort is to create an emotionally bonded customer. So we had a product in which the customer would give us feedback from the market and say, for this particular machine, I'm getting this alternative from your competitor. So what is it that you can offer? So these emotionally bonded customers, they will give you this valuable feedback that will keep your product and marketing process going,
Absolutely right, sir. You're absolutely to something which is called as a pre-commerce stage to a commerce stage. See, today 90% of MSME segment who produce indigenous products for industries would be basically at a formation stage or a formulation stage based upon the industry awareness that they have, the research that they do with regards to their peers, and also understand from the customer what are they looking for before the entire product can be even taken into consideration. Which means there is something which is called as before even production, an assessment which is done by both the vendor as well as the user to identify if the said company is able to produce something matching all the aspects, not just related to production, but also with relation to environment, safety, quality, all those prescribed norms. And when this happens, you are at a pre-e-commerce stage, which means a stage of consideration to become a possible set of vendor for an aligned industry into another country, could be even within the country. And when this happens, there is an evaluation stage. So what happens in a B2B integrated model is, before you basically identify a customer, today it's all digitally done, they basically run your RFPs, proposals, see your capabilities, maturity, they analyze your plan, they come across and review the entire aspect of it, they look at with your R&D, do they see that you have capabilities of investing into your R&D or not? If not, they come partner with you, where there are companies like Turbo Energy Limited, which is tied up with BorgWarner, and BorgWarner is tied up with Toyota. Toyota has got Hino products, Toyota has got Lexus, Toyota has got other products such as Datsun and others also. So the entire pre-commerce evaluation happens before they consider you to be a vendor. And then the evaluation happens at the test phase to identify if you can produce the product that they're looking for. Example, if you are a supplier even to SKF or let's say, for instance, any other company which is KSF and others, you basically are trying to do this and then you come into a commercial aspect, which is where you are getting a feedback from not only the procurement team, the R&D team and rest of the team to give you a clear-cut identification in terms of, yes, your product meets the benchmark, it is commercially viable, we can take you and accept as customers, and the entire phase of it is happening today on digital mode. Now see, we have L&T which is there. L&T has got an e-commerce portal on which you register yourself as a vendor, the set of, you know, other things that they happen. They have stringent norms to meet the end customer requirements. So everything happens fully at that level. Now the experience that is there is an experience of individual people who connect with you at these levels. So whatever happens in the formulation stage or a pre-commerce stage or a commerce stage has completely experienced by the people. That includes the purchase person, the decision maker, the influencer, and also the user who basically constantly keeps in touch with you, including the R&D and others who are tertiary influencers to this. And the entire aspect of it then pushes something which is called as a product delivery. And once the product is delivered, you create a loyalty matrix. And once the loyalty matrix is created, as we said, the moment of purchase, then you reuse, resupply, re-help them and start giving them enhancement, start giving them upgrades, the entire influence loop starts. And why we learn this is, in a realistic view, your customers have an absolute idea of what your product and service got to do with them. So they see something which is called as scalability, relatability, expansion. What is the value of investment? Periodic investment for repeated ownership. Then most importantly, they also start evaluating something which is very critical, which is called your influence among the intermediaries to continuously, periodically evaluate your service offerings or product offerings. Now, please understand one thing. For strategic account management, key account management, and global account management, the person who's in charge for this business is a subject matter expert in himself to identify the changing need. That's what I said, 80% of your time will go into account maintenance. What I mean by account maintenance is not the maintenance that normally you go and do, go have tea, coffee, and come back. Here you do a plotting, like your customer does a plotting with you, to find whether you would be of use in future or not. And when you do this, that's where the four stages of customer journey basically starts. Even if you're a customer who's a new customer, an existing customer, or a periodic customer, there is a stage which is called the inquiry stage. There is the stage of constant comparison. There is a stage of constant movement of purchase. And there's a stage of installation and reuse. So hence, whenever you have this concept when it comes to a customer journey, please remember these four stages. These four stages repeat n number of times within a system. Usually, if it is for a product or a service stage, this is repeated at least 16 times in the customer journey, which is basically called the buyer journey matrix. That's the reason they have evaluation of three or four bidders or five or six other people, and the entire aspect of this comparison starts. And please do understand one thing. Some of them are real experts in comparison, but many of them are not. And that is where your role comes into play with what fact findings you do about not only yourself and your product offerings, but also about your competition and the relative understanding of the industry. And you are a subject matter expert related to that industry. When you do this, you basically differentiate between today's journey and the ideal journey that the customer is looking for. Please understand, people at your customer ends are also not 100% experts. That is where you have various stages in the purchase process. You have the awareness stage, you have the consideration stage, before which comes an information stage, where they are constantly evaluating before you even can even think of selling. And the last but the final stage is the action stage. And when the action stage happens, that's where the moment of truth happens, where the moment of purchase happens. And hence, if you want an ideal customer journey, you have to fill in the gaps between what is your today's journey, which means if you have a sales pipeline or a marketing funnel and you have your customer's requirement being met by multiple calls that you do with you, or a three-click which is there on your e-commerce portal like in Amazon, you select, you check, you basically see which is better for you and then make the purchase. You have to evaluate how the customer is perceiving the ideal journey to be, because they want to be rightly informed about the product. Next important thing that you need to understand is, start by defining your goal. What is your goal? Every product that you offer, every service module that you give has an ultimate goal, which is aligned to the KPI or the function's final objective. And when you align yourself to the function's final objective, the installation becomes complete. The moment of purchase brings a positive post-purchase experience, and the loyalty loop brings an influence loop in infinitum. And when this happens, you're not trying to navigate across with a compass. You are actually doing scientifically. These are called trigger points in customer journey map, which enables you to move forward in the direction in which you can make a customer realize that his need is being fully met without even having to sell to him. And when this happens, you know where the experience is going to take him. The customer also has an idea and he has a future expectation. So varied forms of selling, especially if you're in key account sale, where I've done this for about 15 years of my career, I've done key account, strategic account sales and global account management. There are a few important questions. The customer is decided by the people who are at varied levels within the organization, Nukunji. Now, if you have an open conversation, which is basically called partnership conversations, there is this new format wherein you're basically approaching the customer in the form of snap selling. Snap selling ka matlab ye hota hai ki customer ke situation se, uske perspective se situation ko samajna. Even if it is in a B2B environment, Nikunji, every individual has got deliverables. Would you agree to that?
Yeah, absolutely. But then the delivery will be huge. Customer. For a consumer product, let's say any automobile, let's say,
absolutely,
each customer will have a different taste altogether.
Absolutely. Now, Nikunji, when I approach you, my first point of view is to understand at your level, what are your deliverables? So in my sales conversation with you, if I'm a key account manager, I will have a checklist in terms of understanding what is Nikunji's deliverables. And this will be project-specific deliverables, Nikunji, not the KPI that you specifically carry in your job.
Yeah.
Because you will be evaluated on every purchase that you make.
Yeah.
And hence, you have to find out what are the pain areas and what are the critical areas on which he is going to award you or believe you on this. So, first we do something which is called personal mapping. Personal. It is not P-E-R-S-O-N-A-L. It is personal mapping. Who are the different people? Who are the who's in the organization? What are their roles? What are their deliverables? That's the first mapping that you do in key account.
Okay.
The second mapping that you would do is, what are their expectations with regards to the technical bit? Now you will classify the person based upon technical know-how, commercial know-how, or what aspect is his influence level, which means you're trying to categorize a person into one particular commodity area.
Yeah.
Right? So if I can just proceed.
Yeah.
And just show you all, and then we'll get over with this. So what you sell totally depends upon just not your list of products and services, what the customer is looking for, because it would vary. So selling is not the aspect which is there. What you have to understand is how do you categorize based upon industry, based upon relationship, based upon deliverables, and trying to map the entire journey, which could be very, very difficult when it comes to industrial selling or a B2B selling or a B2 enterprise selling, and could be very, very simple also in terms of a B2C, but again, complexities of how you look into the data analytics. Now, understanding the complexities is very important. So too many products, too many situations. Please don't create a mess out of your customer journey. Please create something that you can take and handle. Customer journeys are absolutely frustrating to create if you have not created it well. And hence, it would be also very important for you to understand how to start with the customer journey. So first thing that you have to do is the scope of the map. Define very clearly to yourself that what is the scope of the map. Please take this into immediate consideration. Understand which segment of customers do you want to cater to. If it is a B2C also, which segment? If it is a B2B and a B2 enterprise, which classes of clients you want to take forward to? Then it's straightforward customer journey. Understand the current customer journey. For one consumer, one product. If it is for B2B, it is one customer, one particular product offering, which is your pioneer product offering in the market, which brings you 80% of the sale, where possibly competition can basically take business away from you. And when you do this, you can focus on the customer journey. So this is where how the focus happens. So clearly define the scope, what products and services is most straightforward understood by the client, because in this feedback has to come from the client. What is the goal of the journey and the journey of customer and the organization, which means you both put together. Once again, like, you know, you had asked a very important question. You are involving the individual also. Even in a B2B, individual is as critical as the organization itself for the end result, because the individuals are responsible for getting the end result. And once you do this, you're done with the entire process of creating a customer journey map. It's easy said and done, but difficult once you follow it, and it takes time. Thank you so much for your time, ladies and gentlemen. I end the session with this, and now I'm open to questions.
Thank you so much, sir. It was a...